Namaskar from United Arab Emirates. My name is Mikhail Matanovich and I'm International Coordinator of Kathmandu Podway Company. We're planning to implement urban, modern, safe and fast transport, and what is the most important, ecologically clean. This transport can carry passengers and cargo as well. We are now in the passenger model of this transport for the capacity of 25 people, even up to 30 people. And if you look at goods, you can see we are on 7 to 10 meters above the ground, what is very safe regarding that we don't disturb any other transport on the ground. That's make us easy to reach fast and safe on our destination. This vehicle can be equipped with air condition or heating, or it can be with windows slightly open. So in Nepal condition, it can run on cold areas, same as in hot areas. This type of transport can be customized for the many different purposes. First purpose is for the public transportation. It can be in this kind of shape to make space and comfort for all kind of passengers. But for long-term distance, it can be customized same like in airplanes. It can be added displays with movies, with music, with games, and you name it. This transport is powered by electrical energy. Electrical energy is straight in the rails above our heads on the tracks. In a case we have blackouts, what can happen and happening sometimes in Nepal, this vehicle is powered by extra batteries, and batteries can push this vehicle up to 23 kilometers, or it can also be customized for the purpose and the location. In a case that our vehicle gets out of even backup power, we have next vehicle that can connect and push or pull the vehicle to the first exit or first station. Same with cargo transport. In a case that we don't have any option left and we need to go out from the vehicle, we have here emergency exit system, so we can put the vest on and we can safely and slowly go out of this vehicle. These vehicles can be equipped with special cameras, safety cameras, that can monitor entire situation and warn the control room for any situation. And we have here the communication tools, so we can communicate directly with control room.
This front of us is a presentation of rails. Rails of the string technology of Podway. As you can see here, rail is created from several components. On the top of rail, there is an aluminium frame, and on the left and right side, and in the middle, there is a steel rail. In this steel rail, going full power electricity, what supplying the pods. So the wheels consuming the electricity from the rails. Under the rails, you can also see the place for optical internet or some other cables. On the tops are steel wires or strings that hold entire rail. It's a total string 30 pieces. Yes. This model of rail can hold up to 50 tons, and that make it unique in the modern railway system. Mr. Said,
how are you doing?
Me again. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, Duke.
I'm sorry to bother you, but I have to inform our people about benefits and advantages of this type of transport. So, tell me please, this type of, or this size of station can control how many kilometers of the
It doesn't matter.
I mean, after probably certain number of kilometers, you need to have backup or second station or third station.
Yes, it depends upon the regulations and what is the requirement of the client. Mm-hmm. But one station is enough to control for all the line. Yes, manpower is needed in case of maintenance. Mm-hmm. Then we need to provide the manpower to do some rectification. But in case of controlling, one is enough.
So in a case in one city you have a line of, let's say, 6-7 kilometers, but you have 3 or 4 lines of 7 kilometers. Mm-hmm. Is this optimal to have one control room, or you need backup or second as well?
One is enough. Yes, but it's always a room for the backup. Mm-hmm. If it is required by the client, like it is really big line, like maybe 500 kilometers
okay.
long.
Okay.
So in that case, yes, we need to provide some extra help or for some backup.
Okay.
But one is enough.
And they are all in a network, and in a case one shut down by some reason,
yes,
the second will hold the entire operation arm.
Yes. But in any case, even if there will be backup, there will be only 2 operators mm-hmm. at same place for backuping each other. So there will be no third interference.
Okay.
Because since the all everything is controlling autonomously, mm-hmm. so no need to touch anything.
Okay.
So if there are more than 2 people, there will be miscommunication. There a lot could be happen, like because of miscommunication. So there will be 2 trained operators mm-hmm. will be sitting right next to each other in case of emergency. That's it. Even if there is backup station, people will only be there for technical support or help, not for the monitoring.
Also, it can be controlled online, right?
Yes, but
in
there are
extreme situations.
In extreme situations, because there are a lot of limitations mm-hmm. To control online, and that limitations are purposely created.
Okay. Yes. Okay. So basically, if somebody break into your control room, tie you up, or eliminate you from your work mm-hmm. location, he cannot create dangerous situation himself using this equipment.
No, no.
The system will automatically recognize it
yes.
and alarm and do the.
As of this track one, mm-hmm. We have demonstrated it already, and we. Make a lot of limitations for 2 vehicles like Yukon and Yukar.
Okay.
Okay, so on this track, since this track is
small. So we put a limitation that these two vehicles cannot be moved simultaneously. Okay. Means one is moving, other has to be stopped because it's very small.
Please, Mr. Saj, explain me what we are looking at here. What is extremely important during the operation of string transport?
First of all, let me explain where we are now. Here, this is operator room of Unitsky String Technologies, Sharjah. Okay, yes. From here, we can control everything that is needed for the movement of the vehicle.
Okay.
All on every technical level, like this is for a small line you see over here.
Yes.
Two dots. These are the two vehicles. One is UCAR, another one is UCON. You can see even designation of the vehicles.
Okay.
Over here. And when it moves, you can take an overview of the vehicles that are in motion and active on the track. You can see there's three more tracks, which are the bigger track. This is like future of the Unitsky String Technology here in Sharjah.
Okay.
Track four is under commissioning now. So as soon as it will be ready, like full-fledged ready, so the vehicles will be displayed over here also. As of now, we are still commissioning. There are final step which remains is of traction power supply.
Okay.
So it will be ready. I hope it will be ready in next month by April or May. So by that time, we will be testing every aspect of the uBus, which is on track four. We can monitor, control everything from here, including track four, track one, and in future there will be even more tracks. We can control everything and monitor everything from here. The only case we need to interfere, like the operators over here, there will be two operators over here. Only time they need to interfere in case of any emergency. If there is no emergency or some minor bugs or some glitches, the software can repair these bugs or rectify themselves. In case there is some big physical damage, in that case only the vehicle will notify or inform or flash the warnings over here, and then the play of operator comes in place. What is needed to be done, the operator will do his duty.
Okay, thank you for this. The vehicles are machines for itself, and they have the risk level of heats, pressure, the brake systems. All this is easy to monitor on your systems, right?
You can monitor everything from here. Like you can see power system.
Okay.
This is the power system. What is the power level?
Mm-hmm.
What is the voltage?
Level.
Like supply from the portable battery, mm-hmm. like in case of emergency.
Mm-hmm.
And for our small vehicles, this is the main power supply.
Mm-hmm.
For our bigger vehicles, these batteries are like backup batteries,
mm-hmm.
because power will be supplied from the traction power system from the track.
Okay.
From here, we can monitor what is the power delivery of the inside the vehicle, what is the lower power delivery inside the vehicle, what is the charge in the woofer batteries, what are the contactors active and what are working. Cooling system, you can see every detailed aspects of cooling system over here.
Mm-hmm.
What is the temperature inside the battery? And by the way, batteries and the motors are manufactured by us,
mm-hmm.
and fully programmed by us. We are developing it from the scratch. So everything, every step you see here is step by step designed by us or our group of companies.
So entire software is developed by
yes, one of our company, which is UER, United Vehicle Robotics, is responsible for the softwares and automations also.
Okay, very interesting. So you have also internet signal from this room.
We have connected everything from hardwired.
Okay.
Only the vehicles are wireless. The rest everything I think is hardwired and closed system, so that nothing can interfere us from outside to make it even more secure.
Okay. Very nice. Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
I'm standing in front of the UCAR, one of the vehicles, where I'm gonna demonstrate how the evacuation of the vehicles happening in the really worst scenario. But we don't expect this, but in a case this happened,
we have the plan C for evacuation, and we are going to demonstrate it. Thank you, and see you on the test ground.
You can come more close.